Hello guys, this is Ravens from Digi Integrity. Welcome to Tech News episode 133. Weeks after a powerful solar flare created a blackout over the Atlantic, a solar storm is headed towards the Earth, likely to hit the planet on Tuesday and Wednesday. It is called a geomagnetic storm. The high-speed stream of solar wind is expected to hit Earth's magnetic field as weather forecaster issues warning. IQ7 Legend is available with a discount of ₹2,000 on its price. The company will also offer no-cost EMI option and up to 6 months on the IQ Z3. Exchange bonus of up to ₹2,000 is also applicable. Amazon Prime Day sale is scheduled for 26-27 July in India. Ahead of the upcoming Prime Day sale, the e-commerce giant is offering discount on various Apple products including iPhones, iPads, MacBooks and many more as part of the Apple Days sale. The biggest highlight of the Apple Days sale is in iPhone 12, which is available for a massive ₹9,000 discount. The iPhone 12 based 64GB storage variant can be bought for ₹70,900 Indian rupees. Kindly look into the screen for the variant wise price and discount of the Apple products. Logitech has introduced a new wired gaming headset in India, which is called as Logitech G335. The gaming headset is a toned version of Logitech G733 Lightspeed Wireless RGB gaming headset. The Logitech G335 comes with a price tag of ₹6,795. The headphone is available in white and black color option. And it is important to note that these are wired headsets. So if you are looking for wireless option, there is a Logitech G733 gaming headset that is available for purchase in India for ₹15,495. Nokia introduced the X series handsets including the Nokia X10 and Nokia X20 back in April. The SAR values of both these handsets were recently spotted on a Nokia India website, hinting towards an imminent launch. Today, Nokia India has started teasing a new smartphone launch for the country. The teaser confirmed that the upcoming Nokia handset will launch in India on 27th of this month. This could be the Nokia X20 or its rugged edition. The X20 is priced at around €350, that is roughly around 30,720 rupees for the 6GB RAM and the 128GB storage variant. Since Indian pricing is mostly cheaper compared to the European pricing, we can expect the handset to launch around ₹25,000 mark in the country. OnePlus Note 2 will be the first smartphone to run on Oxygen OS 11.3. It is the first Oxygen OS build that uses OnePlus and Oppo's shared codebase. Other OnePlus smartphones will migrate to the set codebase via Android 12 update. YouTube's TikTok competitor YouTube Shorts is now rolling out globally. The service launched first in India last year before expanding to around 26 countries including the US and the UK. Now YouTube Shorts, which is still in beta, will be available across more than 100 countries around the world where YouTube is available. Oppo has released a white paper on 6G technology. The company talks about an AI cube as a way to allow 6G networks to become self-optimized. 5G network rollout in India is yet to begin. Fujitsu, the Japanese company, has introduced a launch event for new products in India. The launch event may hold something interesting in the shape of what may potentially be the lightest 13-inch laptop around. While the Fujitsu invite does not specify any product, the presence of laptop in the invite as well as a catch line of lighter than light does suggest that it may be an event to introduce the company's thin and light laptop portfolio in India. Asus ROG XG Mobile eGPU have been launched in India. It serves as an eGPU dock for the recently launched Asus ROG Flow X13. Asus ROG XG Mobile eGPU price in India starts at ₹69,990 for the GeForce RTX 3070 model. Battlegrounds Mobile India currently has over 16 million daily active users, which is one of the highest of the Google Play Store. Furthermore, the developer has also pointed out the game surpassed over 34 million cumulative users within a week of its release, which is claimed to be a new record on the Google Play Store by Krafton. Moreover, the Battlegrounds Mobile India Battle Royale currently has 2.4 million concurrent players in the country. Google announced its Unified Drive for desktop application, which will replace the sync and backup for individuals. For reference, back in 2017, Google split off its desktop drive app in favor of backup and sync for individuals and driver for desktop, which was strictly for business users. Now the Alphabet subsidiary is going full circle and again releasing a new drive app for Windows and macOS. Starting on July 19th, Google will begin transitioning its users to the new Drive for desktop application. Then from August 18th onwards, users still on the backup and sync application will start receiving an in-app notification guiding them to transition to the new Drive application. From October 1st onwards, Google will shut down its backup and sync app and users will no longer be able to sign into that platform. Poco F3 GT will come in two color options in India. The smartphone is also said to feature an anti-fingerprint matte finish. Poco is yet to announce the launch date of the F3 GT. Tecno Camon 17 series India launch date is on July 15. The lineup is expected to include two models, Camon 17 and Camon 17 Pro. The phones will be available via Amazon during the Prime Day sale that is scheduled for July 26th. Samsung has just signed a deal with Tesla worth nearly $500 million. The lead will have the former supply the latter with camera sensors for the latter upcoming electric vehicle, the Cybertruck. The Samsung latest camera modules will be used in Tesla's Cybertruck. For those unaware, the Cybertruck is a futuristic looking electric SUV designed that it was first unveiled back in 2019. The prototype model from back then was equipped with an array of cameras connected to the dashboard screen featuring a mirrorless design. Samsung Galaxy S22 camera specifications and tentative launch date have been leaked online. One Galaxy S22 variant will feature a 200 megapixel camera and an Olympus branding. Samsung is expected to launch the Galaxy S22 series in January 2022. Samsung Galaxy A22 5G launching in India soon. The handset originally launched in June alongside the Galaxy A22 4G model. Samsung Galaxy A22 5G specifications include a 6.6-inch Full HD Plus display, 48-megapixel camera and a 5000mAh battery. Redmi K-series smartphone usually debut in the first half of the year. The only expectations are Redmi K30 and Redmi K30 5G which were announced in late December. Hence, it is not surprising to learn that the upcoming Redmi K50 series will be launched before the next Spring Festival, which will fall on February 1, 2022. For those unaware, the Spring Festival is another name for the Chinese New Year. Several Oppo Reno 6Z 5G renders have shown up online. They showcase the phone design, triple rear cameras and confirm that it will run a MediaTek Dimensity 800U processor. Oppo will unveil the Reno 6Z on July 21st in Thailand. Vivo Y72 5G complete specifications have been revealed. The handset will come with a 6.58-inch Full HD Plus display, Snapdragon 480 processor and a 48-megapixel camera and runs on Android 11 OS. Vivo Y72 5G price in India is expected to be around 22,990 Indian rupees. Apple will not add periscope lens to iPhones until 2023, but the company is definitely working on the matter and has at least two patents on periscope. The periscope system with two prisms and a stack of lens between the two. The stack will provide autofocus and may also be configured to do optical image stabilization. This is interesting because the typical periscope we have seen in smartphones have only one lens, but it also uses it for optical image stabilization purposes, not the lens that follow it. Apple's patent thus offers a possibility of using one or both of the prism to do optical image stabilization. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.